Batteries. Not the first thing that comes to mind when you think about paint, but maybe that'll change for the both of us by the end of this video. Welcome to the 18th episode of my paint and pigment making series, where I'll be seeing if I can make a pigment and a Van Dyck Brown out of carbon-zinc batteries at the request of one of my lovely patrons. The battery part sounds pretty sketchy, but it's really not that bad, so let's get straight into it. To explain what's about to happen in the briefest way possible, a zinc carbon battery is basically a battery that works through an electrochemical reaction between zinc and manganese dioxide. You have the zinc as the outer layer, and you have a carbon rod going through a paste made of manganese dioxide and ammonium chloride. I don't know how it makes electricity, but that's what the battery is made of. For this specific video, I'm interested in the manganese dioxide. I'll try to make zinc oxide out of the outer casing at a later time because it involves fire and I shouldn't be doing it unsupervised. So, manganese dioxide is an inorganic compound which occurs naturally as the mineral pyrolusite. I have no idea how to say it.
Pyrolusite or pyrolusite.
But basically, this is where umber and burnt umber come from. It was also one of the earliest natural substances used by human ancestors in body painting and cave painting. And that brings us to Van Dyck Brown. Van Dyck Brown, also known as Castle Earth and Cologne Earth, was a brown color named after the painter Anthony Van Dyck. It was first made from peat or soil gathered from the iron oxide rich earth found in Kassel and Cologne, Germany. It was also very beloved by Bob Ross, and he'd use it for his trees, cabins, and base coats. Now, we know that all the stuff in our modern paint tubes is pretty much all completely synthetic. And the synthetic version of Van Dyck Brown, the very one in this tube right here, is a mix of manganese dioxide and iron oxide. So, hypothetically, I should be able to replicate it. So, let's get into the action. Feel kinda bad for sacrificing a brand new battery for this, but they degrade with use because the ammonia attacks the zinc and apparently things leak and I don't really wanna deal with that. I'm wearing gloves because it's a battery and it can't be that safe, but also because manganese dioxide stains skin. I'm gonna start by using pottery and clay tools to try to pry the sides off. I don't really have a plan for how I'm going to open up, so I'm just testing out different things. I managed to lift off a little piece, and now I'm using little pliers as a kind of tin can opener, or like those old school twisty key can things. So, I know earlier I said that the outer casing was zinc, but what I've just removed right now is steel, I believe. The zinc is still inside and under that blue plastic. And there's the zinc. I think I finally see the carbon rod and I'm gonna try to pull it out. I'm not really sure what I'm going to do with it yet, so I'll just set it aside. After I remove the cardboard, I finally hit the manganese dioxide and there seems to be a really decent quantity of it. I use a little scooper to scoop it all out. You can definitely tell that there's liquid ammonia in it because the powder is wet and clumpy and not dry at all. I ended up with a pretty large pile of the manganese dioxide, which I'm happy about. It's very black though, and I wonder if it'll end up having any tones to it. The next step is to flush some water through it to remove the ammonium chloride, so I place it in a filter and just wash it with tap water. I repeat this maybe 3 or 4 times, letting the powder dry between each wash. After it's completely dry, I put on my respirator and place some of the pigment into a mortar and use a pestle to grind it up. I only need a small amount though, so I'll just use a little bit and store the rest. After I grind it, I put it through a very fine mesh. Particles look very fine and I'm pretty optimistic about how this will turn out. I'm going to start out by just making a swatch of the pigment by itself. I load up some walnut oil into a syringe and gradually keep adding till I get a good texture. I would usually use my muller to mix it up, but this pigment is just so pigmented and I think it will be a nightmare to clean off the frosted glass. This paint has a very nice sheen to it, and it's actually quite beautiful. I know it's a weird comparison, but it looks like liquid leather to me. This could be because the particles aren't fine enough, which I suspect they aren't. It paints on really nicely, but it turned very matte. It's an extremely dark and deep black that sucks in light, and I'm kind of feeling that. The paint also holds texture very nicely and doesn't fold into itself. That's probably because I finally didn't add too much oil. Under the first swatch, I'm trying to make a glaze by thinning the paint, but it's so rich and pigmented that no transparency is coming through at all. If you've been looking for a very opaque black, you would probably love this. I tried to make a second transparency test, but even that was too dark. Anyways, moving on, I take some titanium white and mix it with the manganese. And it just looks like a regular gray, but a nice one. It doesn't feel very cold or artificial, it's like a natural gray. I also just make a quick swatch of the manganese with some acrylic gel, and the texture is really quite beautiful. I like it a lot. Now that we see what the pigment looks like by itself, the next step is to tackle the Van Dyck Brown. Here I have some regular commercial Van Dyck Brown oil paint, and I'm going to start painting swatches to serve as a comparison. It's very, very dark, but definitely has brown undertones. I'll make a glaze and then mix with white to better see its tones and tints. So as a glaze, it looks just like mud. It has a yellow undertone though. When mixed with white, it turns very gray, and you can see the manganese influence pretty clearly. So in this bag I have some iron oxide that I bought pre-made, and I'm just going to drop some of it into the manganese paint. I'm not going by any measurements here, just kind of eyeballing it. It's definitely turned brown and very earthy, which is a good sign. So by itself, it looks identical to the store-bought Van Dyck Brown. But as soon as I start thinning it, you can see that it has a very red undertone, which makes sense. I thought maybe I had accidentally made burnt umber instead, but in comparison, it was still really off. So I'm not really sure what brown this is. If it looks familiar to you, please be sure to let me know. I had a hunch, though, of something else that might make the perfect Van Dyck brown, and that thing is Nile silt. I have some clay that I'd gathered last year from the Nile, and I remember that the reason it was so dark was because of its manganese content. Deciding that there's nothing to lose at this point, and realizing that it's not worth its own separate video, I grab some dried bits of clay and I just crumble them with my fingers. This is bad practice, but it's quick. I honestly just want to know if the tone is right. I use my fingers to mix it with oil like some kind of caveman, and then I smear it onto the canvas. And what do you know, it's a perfect match. They are pretty much identical. At least, I can't see any difference between the two. It's unfortunate that Nile silk is not as accessible as batteries, but it's better than nothing. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, comments, suggestions, please leave them below. And as always, thanks for watching.